Welcome back. Well, concerns this morning, the Brisbane and Byron Bay COVID outbreaks could be spreading, with fears Brisbane's three-day lockdown could be extended over Easter.
For more, we're joined by Chair of the Coalition for Epidemic Preparedness, Jane Holton. Good morning to you. People have been understanding, Jane, and I think no one wants to point the finger, but this rollout, it hasn't been fast enough, has it?
Well, I think we all understood in the first week or so why it is that vaccines weren't being rolled out very quickly. People had to get their systems in place. But they've had weeks. And I do think now we can all start asking the question about when the vaccine doses that have been delivered to all the states and will actually be fully rolled out to immunise people, particularly our frontline health workers, but also people who are vulnerable. So, yes, I would like to see speed and real focus and attention on this now.
It was described yesterday as unfortunate that a nurse treating someone with COVID didn't have one of these vaccinations. It's actually, I think, got to the point now where everyone goes, Brisbane's gone into lockdown. This is actually a disgrace.
Well, disgrace is a big word. I would certainly say it is very, very, very unfortunate, and I am really disappointed that we haven't seen faster rollout. It was reported yesterday that there are tens of thousands of doses in Queensland that remain to be rolled out. Think of the people we could be protecting, could have already protected with those doses. So I want to see those doses in people's arms. The Chief Medical Officer yesterday indicated that he believes that they've been holding doses back for second doses. The federal government is doing that. We do not need the states to be sitting on doses. We want those doses administered, and we want them administered really quickly.
Yes.
Well, Brisbane's been unfortunate with the outbreak, but you're looking at the numbers for all of the states, the rollout is very slow everywhere, isn't it?
Well, a couple of the states have done pretty well. I think we do need to give credit to those states, particularly New South Wales, who've done a really good job here. But this is the point. There is no room for complacency anywhere in our country. And I'm actually quite worried that that's what we're seeing. People saying, oh, well, you know, we don't have much of a problem. It's not an issue. We can just take our time. We can't. There is always a threat. And quite frankly, we want to be, like some of those people in Britain, we want to be able to start travelling again. We have family relationships and the need to trade. We actually need to be able to get our population immunised. As soon as we get vaccine, we want it in people's arms.
OK, there's all sorts of speculation, and it's not helpful, but there's all sorts of speculation about Gold Coast shutting down, going into shutdown ahead of the Easter holidays, about a wider area in Brisbane, including perhaps maybe even the airport. I mean, none of that's very helpful, but what do you suspect will happen over the next 24 to 48 hours, and what are the key markers for us?
So, I mean, because the original cases here were some time ago, I think in the middle of March, people would remember the case of the doctor, for example. The risk here is that the virus has spread in places that we can't yet see. And what we're looking for now is how many cases they diagnose, for example, today. So what we need to see is what those numbers look like. And then, of course, how the contact traces are going. People should look at that list of venues. Did you go to one of those venues and then take the advice, get tested, and go stay home.
It was reassuring to see those long lines, particularly in Byron Bay, where we'll probably see some results coming through soon. But people have been quick to go out and get tested. Do you think that places like Byron Bay with transient populations need to have a lockdown over this Easter break too?
Well, again, as you say, people are being tested in Byron Bay, and we want to know how many people who are in Byron Bay at the moment potentially have been infected. And so, yes, there is a possibility. Now, New South Wales has not taken many lockdown approaches because they have been really quick and good with their contact tracing. But again, if you've been in Byron Bay on holidays, and a lot of people have, go look at that list. Were you in any of those places? And I don't care whether you are in WA or the Northern Territory or Tasmania, if you've been on holidays in Byron Bay, check it out.
Sounds like you're worried about this one, Jane.
I am. I'm actually quite worried. We've been doing so well, and you know, we've been able to have people go back to the theatre in Sydney. You know, things like Hamilton are running. We don't want those things to stop. So we need everybody now to get alert and alarmed. We need vaccines to be administered, and we all need to be on our game right now.
Let's hope the authorities are listening to you this morning. Good on you, Jane. Thank you.